Hi everyone. So this video is about codominance. So codominance is a peculiar concept which is being seen in case of the individuals where both the alleles, okay, when both the alleles of a gene expresses simultaneously, that is what we call it as a codominance. Okay, so here first I will write down the definition for codominance and thereafter we'll discuss what actually is meant by codominance. So when both the alleles of a gene express simultaneously, in heterozygous condition, then it is called as codominance. Okay, so this is the definition for codominance, which means the two alleles of a gene are expressing simultaneously. Okay, so that is in case of the heterozygous condition. So that is called as codominance. So remember, codominance never exhibits the dominant and recessive relationship or the incomplete dominance relationship. So here the two dominant alleles are expressing together in the heterozygous condition, and that is called as codominance. So to understand codominance, we have the various of examples like blood groups in the human beings, sickle cell anemia, MN blood group system, and thereafter we have the coat color or skin color in case of the cattle. So among the four, so first we'll discuss regarding the codominance by taking an example, that is example number one, that is blood groups in humans. So already in the first year, you have learned that in case of the human blood group, the most commonest blood group which is being there worldwide, so that is called as the ABO system. And this ABO system of the blood group, okay, consists of mainly four different types of blood group. The first one is A blood group, B blood group, and O blood group, as well as AB blood group. Of which these blood groups, okay, like A, B and O, were being discovered by Karl Landsteiner in the year 1900. Whereas AB blood group was being discovered by D. Castillo and Steeny in the year 1902. And in some of the references, what we can find is AB blood group is being discovered by D. Castillo and Andriano Sterli. So that is also being mentioned. Andriano Sterli. Okay. So that is in some of the references you can find Sterli and D. Castillo discovered the blood group AB in the year 1902. So this human blood group, which mainly consists of the four phenotypes, A, B, AB and O blood groups, so these are being identified based on the antigens which are being present on the surface of the RBC. So, antigens which are there, so these antigens, okay, so they are regarded as the glycoproteins. And these glycoproteins are present on the surface of RBC. Surface of RBC. While antibodies, so these antibodies are also the glycoproteins, but they are present in the plasma of the RBC. Okay, so both are the glycoproteins, antigen as well as antibody. So these antigens are also called as agglutinogens. Remember, and based on these antigens, based on these antigens, the blood groups are being identified. Now, how do we recognize that the surface of the RBC has a peculiar type of antigen? So that is being determined by the sugars which are being present over the surface of RBC. So based on which sugar is being deposited over the surface of RBC, the antigens are being identified, and based on the antigens, the blood groups are being identified in case of the human beings. For example, on the surface of the RBC, if there is a sugar, that is N-acetyl galactosamine, then the antigen is being regarded as A. If there is presence of alpha D galactose, then it is being regarded as B antigen. And if both the sugars are there, if both sugars, which means N-acetyl galactosamine as well as galactose, alpha D galactose, when both are there, then the blood group is regarded as, antigens are both A and B, and the blood group is AB. And if there is no sugar at all produced over the surface, then it is being regarded as no antigen and the blood group is O. So if it is A antigen, the blood group is A, and if it is B antigen, then the blood group is B, and if both the sugars are there, then both the antigens A and B are there, and the blood group is AB. And if there is no sugar at all, then the blood group is regarded as O. Okay, so this is based on the antigens, we are able to identify the blood groups in case of human beings. Now, the entire blood groups in the human beings is being controlled by a gene that is called as I. So, I means isohemoagglutinogen or isoagglutinogen. So, this I gene which is there, so this I gene has three alleles. So, they are, one is the dominant allele, that is IA, the other one dominant allele, that is IB, and the last one is the recessive allele, that is IO, or you can write it as small I. Okay, so these two are the dominant alleles, and the last one is regarded as the recessive allele. Okay, so a single gene is having three alleles. Usually what we see is each character is being regulated by a gene, and this gene has two alleles. So that is normal. But here in case of the blood group, a single gene having three alleles on the same loci of the chromosome in a population, so that is what we call it as multiple alleles. Is regarded as multiple alleles, which means when more than two alleles are being present on the specific locus of the chromosome in a population, okay, then it is called multiple alleles. That's what I said. A single gene will have usually two alleles, but here on the same loci there are presence of three alleles. So that is why we all call it as multiple alleles. Now, in case of the codominance, how we are able to explain the blood groups as a codominance? So generally when we look after the blood groups, like for example if I take A blood group, so this A blood group, okay, its genotype is IA and IA or IAIO. So this is the genotype for A blood group. Similarly, with B blood group, it has IB, IB, and IB, IO. And if it is for O blood group, it is IO, IO, or you can write small I and small I. Now, the thing here is, when the individual is having AB blood group, so in this individual, there will be the presence of the genotype, that is IA, IB. So here you can see that the two dominant alleles which are being present, so these both the dominant alleles are expressing together. So when both the dominant alleles are expressing together in this heterozygous condition, then there is a formation of an another blood group that is said to be AB. Okay, so here, as the two dominant alleles are expressing together, the blood groups in human beings is an example for codominance. Blood groups in humans is also an example for multiple alleles, because a single I gene which controls the blood group is having more than two alleles at the specific locus. Okay, so that is, you remember, blood group is an example for codominance as well as multiple alleles. So this is the codominance, the first example, that is blood groups in human beings. Next example what we have here is about sickle cell anemia. Sickle cell anemia. So sickle cell anemia is a disease which is being associated with various of the conditions, like sickle cell anemia exhibits codominance. So this is one. Sickle cell anemia exhibits pleiotropism. Okay, that we'll discuss in the later classes. That is a single gene expressing more than two traits. So that is pleiotropism. Sickle cell anemia is an example for point mutation. And sickle cell anemia is an example for autosomal recessive gene disorder. Okay. So here, sickle cell anemia, in context with that of the codominance, sickle cell anemia exhibits codominance. That is, commonly in case of the human beings, okay, the RBC has four chains, that is, two are alpha chains, the hemoglobin, okay, there are two chains of alpha chain, two alpha chains are present, and two beta chains are present in the normal hemoglobin. And the individual will have HbA and HbA. So this will be the two alleles which is producing the normal shaped RBC. So normal shaped RBC. Okay, which are generally circular or biconcave. So that is the two alleles. Okay. Now, if both the alleles are HbS, HbS. Okay. Now, the condition what we get is of the disease. That is, when the individual has HbS and HbS, then the RBCs are sickle shaped. Sickle shaped RBCs are being seen. But when the condition is HbA and HbS, so here what you are able to see is HbA, HbA are dominant alleles. HBS, HBS are again dominant alleles, but when an individual has HBA and HBS, okay, the individual is said to be carrier. So he is regarded as carrier. But both the alleles, dominant alleles, are expressing together. Henceforth, this individual is said to be carrier or normal individual under normal conditions, but may suffer from mild anemia when his body is being exposed to low oxygen, at that time the new RBCs which have to be synthesized, so instead of producing normal RBCs, the new RBCs which will be synthesized, so they start forming sickle shape. So that is because of the condition HBS, HBS. So that is the carrier who may suffer from a mild anemia. So here also you can see that both the dominant alleles are able to express together. So thereby the individual is carrier and may suffer from mild anemia. Okay, he may suffer from mild anemia only when the oxygen levels will decrease. The new RBCs which will be formed, they will be sickle shape. But under normal conditions, he will have the normal RBCs. So these are the two examples which explains about the codominance, where the two dominant alleles, are expressing together. So here in the blood groups in humans, IA, IB is being expressing together. So thereby AB blood group. In sickle cell anemia, HBA, HBS, the two dominant alleles are expressing together. So thereby the codominance. So these are the two examples of which can explain about the codominance. Thank you.